الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الذي أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا فقد قال الله تعالى في كلامه المجيد والفرقان الحميد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ثم لآتينهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ولا تجد أكثرهم شاكرين صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Due to the Lord of the world, sustainer, maker, most merciful, most exalted, Rahmanur Rahim, Rabbi Jalla wa Ala, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Salat and Salam, peace, blessing and salutation be upon our beloved Prophet, beloved of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the beloved one of all the creatures, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallama wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, today we have chosen to describe about to be grateful. Because Allah Jalla Ala and His beloved one, Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, has taught us to be grateful. Allah and His Rasul both has taught us to be grateful. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in his many happening in his life, and he was most grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The companion of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, Ya Rasulallah, why are you praising Allah much? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had replied, Alam aku abdan shakura? Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Let me become grateful because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made me as a mercy for all the creatures. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down me the messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed unto me the great revelation, the final revelation, the Quran. After all, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Alam aku abdan shakura? Am I not been a grateful one? Abdan shakura. Abdan, it means slave. This is the modesty of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the final messenger and the leader of all messengers. Also, he said, abdan shakura, grateful slave for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was the greatest grateful slave on this planet. So his name is Ahmad, subhanallah. What is the meaning of Ahmad? If we explain and if we analyze us, then we'll get that. What is the meaning of Ahmad? Ahmad, it's mean who become most grateful. His name is Ahmad. Those are praising mass Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It calls in Arabic language Ahmad. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was Ahmad. It means he was the most grateful one in this world. Subhanallah. Also his name is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has several names, but the famous name of his Ahmad. Also it was stated in the previous scripture, Ahmad. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will send down to the final nation and his name will be Ahmad. Even the previous scriptures, previous suhifa, suhuf, fi suhufi Ibrahim wa Musa. His name was Ahmad. It means he was most grateful slave one. Subhanallah. So, brothers and sisters, totally this is the opposite of shaitan. To be grateful, this is the ism, opposite ism of shaitanic ism. Because shaitan had promised with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and alhamdulillah we have recited today the ayah, ثُمَّ لَآتِ أَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Surah Araf, ayah number 17. Shaitan was talking with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, then I will assault them. I will come to the children of Adam from their front and from their behind and from their right side and from their left side. Why? You will not find most of them to be grateful. Ma'azallah. Na'uzu billahi min dalik. So we understood from this ayah, from this Quranic verse, the shaitan promised with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will make the children of Adam ungrateful. If we become ungrateful, we have to think we are descendants of shaitan. We are the followers of shaitan. Because shaitan said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la tajidu aktharahum shakirin. I'll try to make them, you will not find most of them. What is that? Thankful. Shaitan had promised with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, inni akhafullah. Shaitan said to Allah, O Allah, I fear you. Kamasali shaitan idh qala lil insani kfur falamma kafar qala inni bariyum minka inni akhafullah rabbal alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated the example of shaitan. What is that? The similitude of shaitan. Shaitan said, O Allah, inni akhafullah. Indeed, I fear you because you are the Rabbul Alameen. Shaitan said, shaitan fears Allah, but children of Adam do not fear Allah. This is the statement of shaitan. Shaitan said, I fear Allah. In the Quran, you can research that. Shaitan said to Allah, I am too much grateful, but I will make your children to be ungrateful. So in Surah Bani says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا. Shaitan was ungrateful with his Lord, because Shaitan was great scholar, مُعَلِّمُ الْمَلَائِكَ, teacher of all the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him individually, but he denied a commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know the story. So this is the shaitanic ism, to be ungrateful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran in another ayah, be grateful to me and to your parents. Subhanallah. Be grateful with those who are helping you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also was grateful with the others. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for those who are helping him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would remember those who are helping him in his stressful environment. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was gratitude with them, those who are helping him. So brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us to be grateful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, washkuru ni'matallah in kuntum iyyahu ta'budun. It means be grateful for the favor of Allah if you become a real worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you have to be grateful. If you claim you are a believer, real believer, so you have to be grateful. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the parents and instructed to the children to be kind with their parents. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, anishkuruli, anishkuruli wali walidayk. Be gratitude. Give thanks to me and to your parents. Subhanallah. Give thanks for Allah and to your parents. Who taught? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another ayah, أَنِشْكُرُ لِلَّهِ وَمَنْ يَشْكُرُ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. Be aware of them and be grateful to Allah. Whoever is grateful, he is grateful for his benefit of himself. So whoever becomes grateful, he became grateful. Why? Because of him. This is his benefit. So he became grateful, because to be grateful, this is a ibadah. To be ungrateful, this is a nifaq, kufur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا. And Allah Jalla ala said in another ayah, إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. I showed the children of Adam two ways, to be grateful or to be ungrateful. So surely, surely indeed, we have to choose the way of to be grateful, subhanAllah. And brothers, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also supplicated this dua, Allahumma lakal hamd, subhanAllah. Allahumma lakal hamd. Oh Allah, surely only for you our praise. Lakal hamd, for you our praise. Lakal hamdu lil Islam. Praise for you for Islam, because you made us Muslim. Walakal hamdu lil iman. Praise for you because our iman, our tawheed. Because only one nation, they say tawheed. only one nation. Those are Muslim, they say Allah is one. Another, all the people, they associate others with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Lakal hamdulil iman, walakal hamdulil islam. Subhanallah. Walakal hamdulil Quran. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, the praise to you, O Allah, you gave us the final statement, Quran. So we praise you. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to say in the state of the prayer, when we stand up from our bowing down, from the ruku, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if someone say, Rabbana walakal hamd, hamdan kathiran, tayyiban mubarakan fi, it will be multiplied much, much, much and much. Allah knows what is the real reward for them. Subhanallah. And Ummu Tafasir, Mufassir, Musannif Ibn Kathir, brought out in his tafsir, and this is also Sahih Hadith. If some slave, if someone say only Alhamdulillah, if someone says only Alhamdulillah, the two angels come to him and they try to write down his reward. This is authentic hadith. And they say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, instruct us how much reward we should write down. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell the angels, O angels, stop writing down. If someone say, Wali Alhamdulillah, angels come and to try to write down the reward. And they say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, instruct us how much reward we should write down for this slave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, stop, write down this the reward. This reward, this Alhamdulillah, will fulfill the scale on the day of resurrection. Subhanallah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, this is also authentic hadith, مِلْ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمِلْءَ الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا أَهْلَ السَّمَاوَاتِ مِلْءَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمِلْءَ الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا أَهْلَ السَّنَاءِ وَالْمَجْدِ. Subhanallah. If someone says this supplication, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfills for him the scale about the day of Qiyamah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also made this dua, Allahumma lakal hamdu kullu wa lakal mulku kullu wa biyadikal khayru kullu wa ilayka yurja'ul amru kullu. Rawah Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Allah, all of alhamd is due to you. It means all praises and thanks only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for the creatures, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hamd, shukur, hamd, only hamd for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shukur can be for the people, but hamd only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hamd for Rabbul Alameen. So Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, the people do not make shukur, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, Fabi yasma'u wabi yubsir وَبِي يَبْتِشُ وَبِي يَمْشِي. The meaning of this hadith, through me, he hears. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, through me, he hears. وَبِي يُبْصِرْ. Through me, he strikes. Through me, he sees. وَبِي يَبْتِشُ. And through me, he strikes. وَبِي يَمْشِي. And through me, he walks. Subhanallah. It means, through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he talks. Through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he walks. Through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he strikes. Subhanallah. Everything we are doing by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every Muslim and mu'min should be grateful. And Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran to be grateful a lot of time, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also taught us to be grateful. And if we watch to the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are many many happening. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used this word alhamdulillah. What is that? When we wake up from our sleeping, what do we say? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us what is the dua. Alhamdulillahilladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. This is authentic dua. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to say after our waking up from our sleeping, to say alhamdulillah, to be grateful. It means to be grateful. Alhamdulillahilladhi ahyana. Praise, all praise and thanks for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us life after having taken it. When we go to our bed and we get sleeping, soul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Soul is taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give return, then we can get up. If do not, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't do, give again, then people cannot awake from his sleep. He became real death. This is the hukum. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soul come out and inside, in and out. Subhanallah. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to say after our waking up, say alhamdulillah. Because you got up, you wake up from your sleeping, you was dead. When you go to sleep, then you say what? Allahumma bismika wa amut wahya. It means, oh Allah, I am going to die. And if you give me your mercy, then I will wake up. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us return our soul. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to say that alhamdulillahilladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana. Amatana, it means maud. Wa ilayhi an-nushur. And it is not enough to get up and we will die forever. Then we will be resurrected on the day of resurrection. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us very interesting thing. When you go to wear your clothing, then you have to say this dua, alhamdulillahilladhi kasani. Because to wear clothes, this is also bless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of people, they do not like to wear clothes. They like to be bare, naked. A lot of people, they do not like to wear, they do not like to cover their bodies. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us the dua because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us tawfiq, and this libas, it was revealed from the heaven. Wa anzalna alaykum libasa. When Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was descended this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also with his sent down his libas from the heaven. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to say, when you wear your clothes, to say alhamdulillahilladhi kasani haza. It means to praise, all praise for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has clothed me this garment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us ability to cloth, to cover our body with our garment. So we have to be admire, we have to be shakir. And also it's very important thing, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam realized the best in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down him, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood much from all the human being because it was revealed to him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, when you go out, come out from your toilet, you have to praise to your Lord. Because it was your discomfort, it was your difficult to make bathroom, to make toilet, urinate, to make pee and tools. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always is giving us mercy. We are making toilet. Subhanallah. And also Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us this dua. Say, when you complete your bathroom, then you have to say, what is that? Alhamdulillah, alladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa afani wa ghufrana. Subhanallah. A lot of people, they're going to hospital always. They cannot make their bathroom. It is major discomfort and difficulties for them. Those are not making it. But we think this is very simple. No! So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you finish and complete your bathroom, must you have to say, Alhamdulillahi alladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa afani wa ghufrana. It means, O Allah, praise and thanks for you because you removed from me discomfort. Subhanallah. Go to hospital and think about them. Respected brothers, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and taught us to be grateful. And also Allah Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to be grateful. When we finish our food, we forget the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because a lot of people wealthy, they cannot eat their food. They cannot use their properties. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you ability to use that. And you ate from His favor. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to be grateful. What is that? Say, Alhamdulillahilladhi at'amana wa saqana wa ja'alana muslimin. Subhanallah. If we ponder about that, our tears can be bring out. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us as a grateful. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the real ability to make a great grateful. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to do like this. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this one, this thing. To say, Alhamdulillah. Mm. Brothers and sisters, and this is the final statement of this khutbah. And inshallah, all brothers and all sisters, I encourage myself and yourself to remember this one, the reward, the fazila of this word. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillah tamla'ul mizan. If someone say, Alhamdulillah, mizan fulfills for him, subhanallah. Scale fulfills scale with the reward. If someone say, Alhamdulillah. And also, Subhanallah walhamdulillah tamla'an aw tamla'u ma bayna as-samawati wal ard. Rawahu Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if someone say, Subhanallah walhamdulillah, feel that which is between heaven and the earth. Subhanallah. Did you realize that? If only we say Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah, then feel the scale, feel the space between the heaven and the earth. Subhanallah. Feel the space with reward. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Subhanallahi wa tam. Subhanallah walhamdulillah tamla'an aw tamla'u ma bayna as-samawati wal ard. If someone only say Subhanallah walhamdulillah, feels that which is between the heavens and the earth. Subhanallah. How the reward is, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had taught us, but we forgot that. It is, we think this is simple, but reward is greatest of the greatest. Subhanallah bihamdihi wa subhanallah al-azim. And also I say it in another Jum'ah, if someone say only Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times a day, his all sins will be forgiven, if it is like the foam of the ocean. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us the messages. This messages from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was preached by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I encourage myself and yourself, only this thing, to remember this word, Subhanallah walhamdulillah, it can be enough for our grave and for our resurrection. Allah can do this. because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave us this instruction. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.